Do you know what truly grinds my gears as a Hashimoto's and hypothyroid expert with 20 years of experience? When my hypothyroid patients tell me that they were recommended statins because their cholesterol levels were high. Now, before I dive in, remember to subscribe to this channel and don't forget to hit that little bell button. That way you get notified every time I release a new video every Wednesday. In the meantime, if you have no idea who I am, my name is Melissa Ramos, nutritionist with a background in Chinese medicine and owner of Thyroid Alchemy. So, are you ready? If so, let's do this. All right, so let's dive into the thyroid and high cholesterol connection. If you have hypothyroidism and high cholesterol, well, you're not alone. In fact, there's a powerful connection here that most doctors miss. So let me break this down in a way that makes sense. Before I dive in, I want to let you know that I'm going to be hosting a high cholesterol and hypothyroid workshop that breaks down even more tools than I can even possibly explain in this YouTube video. And you're also going to receive protocols. So if you want to grab it, make sure to click the link in the comments. To begin talking about the thyroid and cholesterol connection, we have to start off with the liver. Think of your liver as a factory that processes cholesterol. When the liver gets clogged, it can't handle cholesterol properly. Your thyroid is like the boss of this factory, and it controls the workers, in other words, enzymes that help to handle cholesterol. When your thyroid isn't working well, these workers slow down, creating, well, a traffic jam of cholesterol. This is especially important because your liver isn't just handling cholesterol, it's also where your body converts T4, your inactive thyroid hormone, to T3, your active thyroid hormone. So when your liver is unhealthy, it affects both cholesterol processing and thyroid hormone conversion. So my question for you is, do you have high cholesterol and hypothyroidism? If so, let me know in the comments. Now, this next section is probably going to surprise you because I'm going to be talking about high cholesterol and iron. Yeah, there's a connection. Your liver is a master iron collector, kind of like a squirrel stashing away acorns for the winter. Think of your liver as an overachieving friend, you know, the one who insists on doing everything at once. Instead of juggling work meetings and social plans, it's juggling iron storage along with a whole whack of other tasks. And trust me, this is where it gets even juicier than your favorite Netflix drama. According to groundbreaking research from Dr. Bruce Ames and his team, did you know that iron can be 10 times higher in organs and tissues than what shows up on your blood work? This means your liver could be storing far more iron than your blood work suggests, directly impacting your cholesterol levels. So picture this, your liver has iron trapped inside of it, sort of like a toy stuck in one of those claws at the arcade. I never could get that darn thing out. So instead of just sitting there looking pretty, this iron starts causing absolute chaos. Imagine that trapped iron like a rusty bike that has been left out in the rain. It starts to corrode everything around it. And this is what fancy science folks call oxidative stress. And this is when your body starts to panic and it says, quick, send in the cholesterol troops for protection. But here's the kicker. Your rusty liver is now too overwhelmed to even process the cholesterol it already has. So now you're stuck in more of a vicious loop than watching cat videos at 2 a.m. So now your liver starts showing up for backup. But your liver is too busy dealing with the rust problem to even handle the traffic jam. So how do we fix this? It's all about getting that stuck iron circulating and moving again. And this requires a precise symphony of minerals. And first, we need magnesium to support your adrenal glands. These glands signal to your liver to produce something called ceruloplasmin. Think of this as a taxicab for your liver. But ceruloplasmin needs copper to be able to function properly, and you can get that from a high-quality beef liver supplement. And copper requires vitamin A, not beta-carotene, but in the form of retinol, which you can find in cod liver oil. When everything starts to work right, well, that iron is no longer a couch potato because it starts to move again, kind of like it got a gym membership or something. And your liver, well, it can get back to its regular cholesterol processing job versus playing traffic cop in a gridlock. Okay, so let's talk about some practical steps of what you can do with this information. First, we need to understand what's really going on with your body. Most doctors will only run a basic cholesterol panel, and that really isn't enough to understand what's going on. So the first thing that I would suggest is a thyroid panel. Now, this is not just TSH. You're also going to have tested your free T3, free T4, and reverse T3 levels. Getting your antibodies tested is also a good idea. Next, get a full iron panel done. This includes iron, ferritin, and your transferrin levels. And last but not least, if you're able to, get your ceruloplasmin levels tested. When it comes to supplements, I recommend magnesium glycinate, which you can take in the evening. It has a calming effect. Vitamin A in the form of retinol, which you can get from cod liver oil, and also copper, which you're going to be able to receive in beef liver capsules. Now, if everything in this video hasn't blown your mind yet, well, buckle up because let's talk about stress. Think of stress as the ultimate panic buyer and hoarder of iron. Sort of like those people who bought 57 packs of toilet paper during the pandemic. No judgment, you're all God's children. But that's exactly what a stressed body does with iron. It hoards it like it's preparing for an apocalypse. And just like how that stockpile of toilet paper isn't really doing anybody any favors, sitting in a storage unit, all that stored up iron is just causing your body chaos. So we need to teach your body that it's safe to let it go. This is where things like meditation, breath work, and prioritizing your sleep can absolutely be vital. All right, you, that is it. If you love this video, do me a favor, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and share it with someone who just might need it. I'll see you next Wednesday.